Hi. Probably by now you have heard the news. Pen Farthing and all his dogs are out of Afghanistan. They are now in London, they are in Heathrow, they are in quarantine, and everything has gone well for the dogs and for Pen. Unfortunately, Pen had to leave all his stuff behind. Let's recap. Is it necessary to recap? If you've been following this channel and you've been following the news and you've been on Facebook or social media, you know the story of Pen Farthing and Nauset. This guy is one of the most extraordinary guys I've ever seen, I've ever met. He's a CNN hero. He's a rescuer through and through. He's an ex-marine. For 20 years, he served his country. Now, he finds himself behind enemy lines. And he said from the very beginning that he will not live without his dogs and without his Afghan staff and their families. What ensued after that was one of the most dramatic and well-run and most engaging campaigns, lobbying campaigns I have ever seen. We all found ourselves glued to the telephone and glued to the screens, lobbying in favor of Nauset, sending messages to Boris, sending messages to Mr. Wallace, the villain of the story, the Secretary of Defense of the UK. And in the end, all that pressure, all that accumulated pressure from millions of people, and literally, I kid you not, we were millions of people, it worked. But guess what? No good deed goes unpunished. The moment Pen has landed in the UK, the newspapers have started a slandering campaign. They publish a dialogue that he had with Mr. Quentin, in which Pen was telling him, look, if you don't get us out of here, I will destroy you. Yeah, these are harsh words, but come on, put yourself in his shoes. He was responsible for so many lives. Think about it. It was the least thing he could say. He was in a position of total stress, tension, uncertainty. He knew, and unless he did something, they were gonna be left behind. And you may say, no, come on. No government can leave their people behind. No government will leave somebody like Pen Farthing with all their animals stranded at the airport. They wouldn't do that, right? Well, guess what? They would. And they would, how do I know that? Because that's what they did with Charlotte, the head of Kabul Small Animal Rescue. She has been left alone at the airport with all her dogs. They told her, look, we're not gonna take you. Release all your animals and go back to Kabul, and God have mercy on your soul. That's what basically they did with Charlotte. On today's video, I wanted to celebrate the achievement of Pen Farthing, Nauset, and the millions of people that have lobbied for him. This is an extraordinary, amazing guy. He returns a national hero. Both Pen and Dominic Dyer, the guy that has been helping him, they are incredible. Dominic is such a force. From here, we've been lending our voices to his campaign, and I know many of you who follow me, you've written to me to personally thank me for getting involved. The only thing I could do was to help them raise funds and to spread their message a bit more. We have nearly a million people in this channel, so that's all we could do. But I tell you, what Pen has gone through, this is really material for a blockbuster movie. Unbelievable. Pen, you're a hero. Truly, you're a hero, and you will always have my respect and the respect from anybody in this organization. Mr. Wallace, Secretary of Defense, you are a piece of shit. Truly, really. And I can say this because nothing can happen to me, and, well, no slandering campaign is gonna happen because I'm just telling you the truth. You're one of the most despicable human beings. I mean, are you a human being? What you did? And then what you did releasing that audio and slandering Pen? Well, in the UK, no one is listening to you. You have completely, basically spat on your own political career. You're terrible. Wallace, should go down. And then we have Charlotte, Kabul small animal rescue, abandoned at the airport with all her animals, forced to release all the dogs at the airport run. Will you believe it? The US Army told her, you know, we're not gonna take your dogs. We're not gonna take your stuff. Release them all. Release the dogs. And she had to release them. But she didn't wanna release a handicapped puppy. So she grabbed the puppy with her hand and she decided to stay in Kabul. Charlotte, you're a hero as well. Unfortunately, her campaign was not organized like Pen's. Unfortunately, people like me or other people, we didn't get involved as earlier. Unfortunately, she didn't communicate with such clarity. We didn't know what was happening with her. I'm so sorry. So on one hand, you have magnificent news. And on the other hand, you have another hero, another rescuer left behind enemy lines. Bittersweet video. Pen, congratulations. Congratulations for what you did. You're an incredible guy. If you ever need me, just contact me. We spoke years ago when I offered to help you finding an alternative route through Turkey for some of your rescues, and I'm here at your service. Charlotte, if you're watching this, be strong. Don't worry, eventually someone is gonna come get you. I promise you that. I'm sure of that. Guys, please share this video. It's an amazing story. Thank you very much, and I'll see you tomorrow.